microcosm of our great nation, reflective of our rich cultural heritage, an embodiment of legacy, shaping ethos, shaping minds. The Indian Administrative Service, IAS, is at the helm of all affairs relating to public policy and administration. Significantly contributing towards nation building, to call it the backbone of any successful government would be an accurate representation. The year 1958 saw the Union Home Minister Pandit Govind Ballabh Pant announce in the Parliament the plans to amalgamate the IAS Training School Delhi and the IAS Staff College in Simla and to establish the National Academy of Administration. Although the decorous institution was unveiled on September 1, 1959 at Metcalfe House, Delhi, it was soon relocated to Mussoorie's Shalville Estate. Ever since its inception in 1959, Lal Bahadur Shastri National Academy of Administration, LABASNA, shoulders the crucial responsibility of crafting professionals that meet the demands of a fast evolving diverse economy.
ভুলি বেদাবে কেন হব সবে আগুয়ান সাথে আছে ভগবান হবে জয়
With eyes gleaming with ambition and hearts brimming with passion, a few fortunate candidates, after clearing competitive civil services examination belonging to a plethora of socio-economic backgrounds, sign up to begin a life-altering journey at LABASNA. A regular day at the academy begins with physical training, mandatory for all officers on training. To make physical wellness an integral part of their daily routine, as well as instill in them a healthy means of venting out daily stress. As the fresh officer trainees enter the regimental routine of the institute, they're first exposed to a foundation course, a common course for entrance to the All India Services, Indian Foreign Service, Group A Services of the Union and the Royal Bhutan Service. Through a well-defined and pedantically designed curriculum, combining classroom tutelage with outdoor excursions, it aims at providing professional expertise, on-the-job training, and dispenses nurturing and appropriate values such as esprit de corps, amongst others. The Academy, on its part, inculcates among its trainees a common set of values and attitudes, cutting across inputs of different academic disciplines. In a rapidly changing world, technology is the fulcrum of good governance and effective administration. The foundation course is designed to equip the trainees with the latest set of tools of information and communication technology. An important component of this course is an experiential village visit, where the OTs are expected to observe and study the ground level struggles of rural life by actively interacting with the residents and listening with intent. The foundation course is one of the most memorable periods in the lives of civil service officers. After the successful completion of the foundation course, the IAS officer trainees graduate to phase one training. This phase imparts a rigorous coaching of a wide range of subjects, enabling them to handle the many assignments that they shall be responsible for during the first decade of their service. An integral part of Phase 1 is the Bharat Darshan. A 6-week winter study tour which gives officer trainees an opportunity to experience the diversity of India. They closely observe the functioning of numerous organizations and thus acquire a pan-India perspective of emerging socio-economic and political trends. The OTs are grouped in a team of 18 to 20 members, where each OT traverses nearly 20,000 kilometers across the length and breadth of the subcontinent, learning on the way his or her emerging role and administrative responsibilities in alliance with other services. 4 zonal days are organized, on which the culture and cuisines of the OT's allocated cadres are explored. Adding to the fervor is the Sangam, the inter-services meet, a stimulating endeavor by the IAS trainees and varied other civil services of India. Spanning over 3 to 4 days, Sangam fosters camaraderie. The eventful Phase 1 segues into yet another exhilarating period of district training, which combines learning by seeing and learning by doing. As the officers on training handle independent charges during this period, to consolidate all that is learnt so far and share experiences gained, Phase 2 of the training program allows for interactive learning, enabling young participants to articulate the strengths and weaknesses of India's administration and governance and seek robust solutions to the present and future challenges. Formerly, a sense of career that had brought them to the prestigious institution has now become a purpose of their life. This was rightly pointed out by the Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi on his visit to the academy. The Prime Minister enthusiastically interacted with the OTs, stressing on the importance of establishing a strong rapport with people as a key to success, and also compared the civil services to the 4th lion of the Ashoka emblem, which remains invisible, yet asserts its undeniable importance at all the times. What is churned out from these rigorous yet exploratory training years is a brilliant batch of young, diligent, rational and steadfast men and women. Beginning their career in public service, they take upon themselves to improve the lives of every Indian. Oh, dhoro mite dhir ho, koro mite bhir ho, unnato shir nahi bhoy. Bhuli beda bet kyan hobo shabe aguan, shate ache bhagoban hobe joy. Raho dharm me dhi, raho karm me vir, rakho unnat shir daro naam.